Hi everybody, I'm Dr. Ejiro Isiorho with Corrective Set Foot Health Center in Tigard, Oregon. If you're seeing me again, that means we're doing another procedure. Unfortunately, we have an ingrown. This is secondary to trying to take care of it themselves and going to urgent care. And you may also notice that this toe, this great toe, is a little bit shorter than the other toes. That's due to a condition called Brachymetatarsia. We typically see it more on number four, but in this case, we see it on the first toe. And if you had a good angle, a good view, you'd probably see it on the other side as well, too. This patient actually has it in her hands, so it's probably a congenital deformity that may or may not be diagnosed. But at the same time, that's not what we're here for. We're here for the ingrown. So we're going to take the ingrown out, and we're going to do a permanent procedure. So if you've seen this betadine, that means it's already been prepped. And you know I like my patients already numb. So, patient, are you numb?
I think so.
You feel anything?
No.
Wonderful. You are numb. So I always like to use a hemostat. Helps to keep one instrument in my hand. I put the smooth part going against the skin and the rough part going against the nail that we're going to remove. And we're going to remove this entire toenail and puts a chemical in there so it doesn't grow back. Now, when I say it doesn't grow back, there's a 90% chance that it will not grow back because unfortunately nothing's 100% besides death and taxes. And there's a joke in there somewhere, but I'll leave that alone. So loosening this up, and this is pretty scarred down, meaning that this is not the first time, this is not the first rodeo for this now. So I'm gonna use my spatula and take a little bit more off of it. There we go, nice and loose now. So now that we have that toe acting like we wanted to, that now acting like we wanted to, now we can get rid of it or pop it off. Wonderful. You okay?
Mm-hmm.
All right. So with it being well adhered because of multiple trauma to it, it's scarred down. So I like to take it all out at once, but unfortunately can't. So graphic warning. That's the nail gone and absent. We're gonna put some chemical in there to cauterize that nail root so it doesn't grow back. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna take my curette. And I'm going to score that nail fold, the proximal nail fold, or the nail matrix, basically the nail root. I'm increasing the surface area so that medication penetrates and it's more effective. Unfortunately, when the ingrowns do reoccur, they usually reoccur in the corners. So I'm going to put a little extra TLC or extra love on that area. So patient, don't be surprised because we're going to be putting a chemical burn back there if the corners drain a little bit more. That is normal and expected. But again, like I said, the pain you had before you came in and that toe was numb is typically worse than the pain you have afterwards. Typically, most people have 3 out of 10 pain or pain that is tolerated or treated well by Tylenol. Now I church this up a little bit, clean it up. I love those breath sounds, wonderful. Going to your happy place. So now it's time for the chemical. We put the chemical burn back there. And if you listen quietly, you can hear the sizzle. Sizzle, sizzle, sizzle. I'm a father, I'm allowed to have bad jokes. So we're putting the chemical down. You can see that's coagulating the blood. Again, we're focusing on the corners because we don't want these corners to grow back. And her toe is going to be so much happier. Because we removed the offending nail border, most likely they will not need any antibiotics. You'll follow the instructions of changing the dressing twice a day for the first 5 days. And then after the fifth day, you'll stop using the antibiotic ointment. After the fifth day, you'll stop putting a bandage on twice a day. After the fifth day, you only soak it once a day. So now that we caused that burn, let's reverse it. I'm cleaning this up a little bit more. So now we're reversing the chemical burn. Or neutralizing it. And again, focusing that concentration medication on the sides. Beautissimo, beautissimo. All right. Everything looks good and clean. So I'm gonna raise you up now. So this is dressing you're gonna keep on for 24 hours. That's your toe. Mm-hmm.
Isn't she lovely?
So this dressing, it's very important that you don't pull it off underwater. You soak it off and you pull. So you put it underwater and you pull it while it's actively underwater. If you pull it while it's dry, like right now, you won't like me, you won't like anybody. Mm-hmm. After you soak it off, you want to clean it with antibacterial soap and water. You want to clean it, you don't want to rub it. And when you get done to dry it, you want to pat dry it. You don't want to rub it. Again, you don't want to make anybody more angry than it needs to be. You're going to do that twice a day. So if you shower daily, that's a soaking. And then you'll take another tub or a bucket of water and put some Epsom salt in there, and that counts as a soaking number two. You do that every day for the next 5 days. On the fifth day, you'll stop soaking it twice a day. On the fifth day, you'll stop using the antibiotic ointment. On the fifth day, you will stop using Neosporin, Polysporin, and Bacitracin. Otherwise, that's that.
Perfect.
Lovely. I think so too. All right, until next time, Dr. Cyril, Corrective Stuff at the Health Center in Tigard, Oregon. Take care.